And now to 12 Responds, where we've been answering thousands of questions sent in to WPRI.com. You might have noticed a new setting on your Apple or Android phone that enables COVID-19 exposure logging. Many people are confused about it and how it got there. Elaine writes, why was the COVID app uploaded to our phones without our permission? Eyewitness News reporter Kim Kalunian spoke with a local computer science expert and joins us now with the answers.
Well, the first thing you should know, Elaine, is that this is not the same as Rhode Island's Crush COVID app. And it's actually Apple and Google that put it there. The goal is to partially automate contact tracing without giving up any privacy.
Open up your iPhone or Android settings and you might see this, COVID-19 exposure logging. So what is it and how did it get there? Brown computer science professor Anna Lisanskaya has been working with a team of experts to figure out a way to automate the often labor-intensive contact tracing process. Their idea? Use something called Bluetooth low energy to figure out when your device is close to another. If that phone's owner comes down with COVID, you'd be notified of a potential exposure.
And all of us thought, well, if only Apple could just create something called an API so that you could build an app on top of it, then this could become reality.
So Apple and Google did just that. The API Lisanskaya mentioned is what's now on your phone, but you'd have to choose to enable it if that time comes.
But at the moment, these apps are still in development. So this is more kind of looking to the future.
So far, about 50,000 Rhode Islanders have downloaded the state's Crush COVID app. It's not currently using the new Bluetooth technology and instead uses GPS tracking, which Lisanskaya says is less precise. A new version of the app is set to be released next month. Meanwhile, the Massachusetts Community Tracing Collaborative says if these technologies meet our needs, including effectively identifying contacts and protecting users' privacy, we will consider integrating those advanced methods into our traditional work. So what about privacy?
There is no private information being exchanged. No actual contact information is being exchanged. When our devices come into contact with each other, all I know is that, oh, I wasn't in proximity to some other device.
So long story short, while the groundwork for this type of automatic anonymous contact tracing has literally been placed in the palm of our hands, how and when it will actually work remains to be seen. In Providence, I'm Kim Kalunian, Eyewitness News.
Thank you, Kim, and please continue to send us your questions on WPRI.com. We'll answer some of them on the air. And remember, you can find answers of frequently asked questions anytime on our website.